There's no doubt about it in my mind. No code, or low code at least, is going to be the future of web development. In fact, I'm so sure about it that I would bet all my money on it. But for right now, what does that mean for you as a designer? What does it mean for you as a developer? Are you going to lose your job as a dev? That's what we're going to talk about in this video. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Arnau. I'm a freelance designer, and on this channel, we explore strategies and tools that help you become a better designer. Now let's back up here a second. What actually is no code? Well, according to Webflow, no-code development is a type of web development that allows non-programmers and programmers to create software using graphical user interface, or a GUI, instead of writing code. The idea that you can build a website without using any code isn't actually new. WordPress has been around for around 18 years. So why has there been a recent boom in the no-code movement? Well, with new tools like Figma and Sketch and powerful website builders like Webflow, you've been given a new ability, an unprecedented ability, to actually build websites and to build websites to your complete control and to the exact precision that you want it, which in turn gives people the freedom to be as creative as they want to be. But there's actually a huge problem here. Now, programs at Webflow aren't that great for really complex websites, for complex functions, right? It's mainly used just for marketing and landing pages. To give an example, I recently had to build a countdown clock for a client of mine, and I still had to use code snippets in the Webflow site. So even though the entire website was built on Webflow and this no-code world, I still had to use code to implement this very simple feature. So still, even really small bits of code like that are still super important, and we still need developers and we still need code, and we're not really rid of code in our lives yet. Now, recently, in one of my last videos, I did a comparison on WordPress and Webflow, and I went into the detail on both. So if you want to watch that video, go ahead and watch that one right here. See, one of the biggest issues with Webflow and no code in general are the integrations. It's been easy for a while now, for actually over 18 years, to build a static website or a marketing page, but integrations are what takes these sites to the next level, and plugins with WordPress or custom integrations with APIs on Webflow are what actually take this website, which is really simple, that you can do something like Wix or Shopify, and you take it to the next level. Integrations are what allow us to kind of break this barrier of no code and take our website to the next level, right? We can build powerful websites, applications, and almost some softwares even today using no code. Now, Zapier is one of those companies trying to integrate no code with other applications. Using APIs in Webflow, we can kind of harness the power of other apps and pretty much integrate them into our own website and create this big complex website. And the beauty of this is that this allows us to have a wider range of capability when we're building websites for clients and for ourselves, and we can start to kind of dream of what this world can really be. But this isn't the end all be all of no code. There's still so much code involved when you're building these integrations and when you're actually connecting a lot of these parts, and sometimes they break and sometimes you need help, and it's just not the end of it. But programs like WordPress and Wix and Webflow have been around for ages, right? There's also some programs that are starting to be able to develop apps without any code. I mean, if you think about it, that's pretty insane. You can build an entire app without using a single line of code. Now, obviously, there's still integrations that you need to do, and there's still APIs that you need to connect, but pretty much most of the front end is no code, which is pretty insane. Now, in this world of no code, we'd be able to solve so many more problems if people don't have that barrier of entry with code. But for me, it's almost a double-sided coin, right? Because at one end, you can build all these products that don't really require code, but on the other end, you need developers to build these products and to build these softwares and programs that allow us to build without code in the first place. And if you think about it, the debate of no code is almost like the debate of robots taking over mundane jobs. You're still always going to need mechanics and engineers to fix those robots and to kind of get those robots going in the first place. But as it stands, I see the progression of no code and Webflow and developing and all that just like the progression of the first printer or the first printing press, right? Like, over time, we start to use less and less the printing press and more the printers, and it's just a natural progression. And that's the way I see no code happening. I see devs being used less and less and no code being used more and more. And that's a pretty bold statement to make, but as I see it, no code is only going to get better. It's only going to improve the ease of it, the integrations, everything is just going to improve for the better. And in my opinion, in the future, we're going to be using no code for absolutely everything. I think that the future is going to be based on no code, but again, we're going to need the devs to build the softwares and to build the tools that allow us to build in no code in the first place. So in the end, devs are never really going to be gone, but I think these tools of no code are always going to be improving. The APIs are going to improve, the integrations are going to improve. So it's always going to be a beneficial thing for everyone. If you guys like this video, then make sure that you like and subscribe, and let me know what you guys think about no code in the future. Do you guys think that devs are going to be used, or do you think no code is going to be always here or gone? What do you guys think about it? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.